number 7 in black to tip it off with Candace Parker. And off we go here in Chicago.
Well, let's see if the Sky can put some pressure on Burton. She's not used to playing heavy minutes with Arike out, so see if they can pressure her a little bit.
Look, Thornton drops down the first three of the night. In this building, had a lot of her Northwestern teammates in attendance for that. Her pass intercepted by Vandersloot. The veteran picking off the rookie. Here comes Copper flying down the lane. Parker back in the lineup and back in the score sheet. Marina Mabry was locked up the last time these two teams met. Just 2 points. A nice pass down low, though, to Burton.
Had them off balance. She's able to take advantage of it.
Copper the crossover and the deuce.
That's too easy for a Kalia.
The Sky Group has won back-to-back games. Vandersloot's been a key part of that. Finds Emma Masonman. That's her game right there. Easy mid-range jump. McCowan battling on the glass. Parker there. A big rebounding boost for the Sky with Candace Parker back in today. Vandersloot down low. 0-2 Candace Parker. That's the veteran. The veteran connection.
You know, the bigs for the Sky are so versatile. Wow, nice shot. Really careful when she catches the rock.
Oh, the block from Burton. Copper able to recover, though, put it off the glass. On Sunday, that was an overtime win for Chicago. Sky up three. They go back down low to Mabry. This time she's going to the line for one more. Mabry did have 22 points in the first meeting between the Sky and the Wings. What a back up there from Copper. Beautiful play.
I think at the NBA level, they've lost some of that here in the last decade or so.
Sky definitely play a team game as Ty Harris knocks down the mid-range jumper. Harrison working against Azari Stevens. That's a fun matchup that Harrison won. Harrison Burton, speaking of pesky, here's Rebecca Gardner. 32-year-old rookie finds Copper. Quick first step. Count it plus a foul. Right on cue as you say that. Mabry's been really good on that end. We are calling for it and finishing.
That's a beautiful.
Typically when Igunbowale's in for them, they're really pushing the pace as Allie Quigley tries a three and knocks it down. Now things can reset for the Sky. Azari Stevens been really good from deep this season. All of a sudden, Dallas with a one-point lead. Kuir, after Stevens tried to jump the passing lane. It just means so much to this group, even if she isn't the one doing the scoring. They're trying to double McCowan, but it isn't working. McCowan leading all Dallas scores.
McCowan gets such deep position that when she catches, there's almost nothing you can do.
When Vandersloot turns on the Jets, you can say the same about her.
That's a great point.
Now Ty Harris with that speed on the move.
Oh, good pass.
McCowan on the finish.
Alicia Gray with the sweet dime. Kalia wanted to shoot that one. She didn't necessarily want to give that up.
Instead, Quigley gets the roll off the iron.
Oh, good tag there by Emma Meeseman defensively.
Kept her arm straight up, but again, the height of McCowan.
They need to space the floor a little bit and see if they can get some cuts like that.
Masonman on the follow-up. What an effort from Emma Masonman. Now she'll await reinforcements here. Sky could tie it with a three. Parker goes off the glass to trim it down to one. McCowan back in the game for Dallas. That's what she's been doing all half long.
Good D by Emma Masonman. She walked. Thornton got away with the travel.
Just three on the shot clock for Mabry. Winding down, found enough space. McCowan secures her ninth rebound. Now just one shy of a double-double. With still plenty of game to go. Mabry catch and shoot three.
Sky didn't have a lot of balance that time.
Maybe it's soft turnovers that the Sky can turn up the pace of this game. On the finishing end is Candace Parker off the feed from Vandersloot.
Nice give and go between Candace and Slooty.
Do you want to see the tempo go up a bit for the Sky right now?
Yeah, because anytime the tempo does go up, they generally get to the bucket. Allie felt like she got fouled right there.
Vandersloot fell, and Harris, beg your pardon, Alicia Gray.
She's not really even looking for her shot.
Meisman had enough space. Drained a big three that the Sky needed. Trying to make it 11 tonight, facing a tough Dallas team. Copper takes it herself. Sky fans love to see that. James Ode is pretty animated in that last timeout. McCollum there, James Wade won't like that.
Alicia Gray wanted the call, obviously, but didn't get it. Oh, good job by Burton.
She had two steals against Atlanta the other day, picks one up there and turns it into points.
They've really got the Sky off balance here, Jason.
Gardner lost it, James Wade wanted a foul. Doesn't get one, back comes Harris with that speed of hers all the way to the rack. PFC, the order.
I gotta stop talking about food. I'm getting hungry.
10-point lead now for Dallas after Thornton's last bucket. Meisman's running the floor. The catch, the fade, and the finish. Consistent free throws for the other team can kind of throw them off. Are you seeing that today with this kind of, it's kind of a sloppy play that Dallas is rolling with as Copper gets to the rim. That isn't sloppy. That's aesthetically pleasing. That's what the Sky want. Under a minute to go in the third. Mabry had the last bucket, looking for back-to-back points, and does it. That's a long two for Marina Mabry.
She's like, hey, we don't have a Goomba Wale, but it doesn't matter. I'm here to step up.
Nice feed, Parker to Stevens.
That's the timing that you just referenced, Jason.
Kind of walked up to her on the bench and said, stay ready.
Stay ready. That's right.
It's the veteran leadership on this group. They lost Alicia Gray there, though, and she gets this Dallas lead back to double digits.
They're up, they're denying first pass, and they're taking the timing away. That's why you haven't seen the good flow from the Sky offense here during most of the game.
Stevens has 9 off the bench in 15 minutes, and she started those last two games in place of Parker. Those two on the floor with each other now. Sierra McCown has been a problem all night, 16 big points.
Figure out a way to get some easy ones like that. That's why there's winning right now.
Mabry. Oh, wow.
I said in the third quarter, and I'll say it again here in the fourth quarter. There are games when your stuff just isn't working for whatever reason. This might be one of them for the Sky.
Quigley, quick catch and shoot.
I love that call. We had not seen that all night.
Meisman, that's a three. A big one for the Sky. This has been the toughest defensive stop tonight, but Azaray Stevens, the big rejection on McCollum.
Look at Azaray running the floor.
Copper off the extra feed. Back-to-back Sky buckets. Free throws for the opposing team. They're in a better rhythm. Quigley catch and shoot three. Steven this time. Instead, it's in the paint. Next to the 4-point game.
Don't need a three here.
Stevens is going to try her hand to the triple. Knocks it down. Quigley catch and shoot three. Meisman in the offensive rebound. Quigley reloads. Just two lefts that'll wind things down tonight as Dallas picks up win number 14 on the season.